Hello everyone, in this video, we'll guide you through the compilation steps for UxPlay on Windows. We'll also show you how to create a standalone build that can be easily copied to another PC or shared with a friend. Let's dive in. The first requirement is the Bonjour Service Dev Kit. I'll download it from Apple's website. If you haven't installed it in the default location, see Program Files, Bonjour SDK, take note of the folder where it is installed. You'll need this information later for compiling the project. Next, we need to set up the MSWise2 environment, which we'll use to build the project. While MSWise2 is being installed, you can download the UxPlay release you want to build and extract it to a suitable folder. Once MSWise2 installation is complete, open the MinGW64 terminal. We'll perform some initial setup steps here. Start by updating the packages using the command pacman syu. If required, restart the MinGW64 terminal after this step. Now we can proceed to install CMake and MinGW64. To easily navigate to the source code folder in the terminal, copy the path where you extracted the UxPlay source code. Note that the MSWise terminal uses forward slashes instead of backslashes for Windows paths. Now, it's time to obtain the UxPlay dependencies. Create a build folder and navigate to it in the terminal. From here, we'll use CMake to create build files and Ninja to build the project. If Bonjour SDK is not located in the C program files, Bonjour SDK, change the Bonjour SDK home variable to point to the correct folder. We still need to install some GStreamer plugins before the app can run, specifically the libav good and bad plugins. Once the installation is complete, we can test running UxPlay from the terminal to ensure everything is working fine. If you want a standalone build that can be used on another PC or shared with a friend, follow this step. Copy the contents of the bin and lib folders from the MSWise2 installation to the corresponding locations in your build folder. This will ensure that all necessary files are included in your standalone build. To make it easier to distribute the application, you can move the build folder to a separate location. Additionally, I recommend creating a shortcut that starts UxPlay from the terminal and uses parameters defined in a file called config.txt. Finally, make sure to remove the default working folder from the shortcut. After completing these steps, you can safely delete the MSYS environment if you won't be using it to build other programs. Your UxPlay application is now capable of running on its own. If you're planning to share the build with your friends, don't forget to provide them with access to the source code as well, so they can explore and enjoy it too. If you found these steps helpful or encountered any issues, we encourage you to leave a comment. By sharing your experiences, we can support each other. Thanks for watching.